going to play some Resident Evil 4, but, you know, it's late.
I don't have enough fuel in my brain for it tonight.
Yeah. So, we're just going to go ahead and we are going to jump into the next episode of Full Battle Alchemist Brotherhood. Episode 16, Footsteps of a Comrade in Arms. That sounds ominous. But I'll just say, I'll say this, the big thing with what's happening so far in terms of the characters being brought in from Xing, basically, you know, seeing like the prince, the two bodyguards, and their interactions.
And the panda.
And the wee panda. The wee little panda. Yeah. Yeah, it's, and also that girl's romanticized version of Ed.
Yeah.
Oh. You just know that as soon as she sees him, she's just gonna be like, what? We're just gonna step headlong into the next episode here. Let's check it out. Let's see what kind of chaos the Elric brothers get themselves into.
I can't take my eyes off him for a second.
No, you can't.
Young Lord!
Oh. Well, there he is.
Something about this country doesn't feel right.
Oh.
Hey, it's the smoking guy.
How's it going? You want a single game yet?
Since it's night now, I can go and cut someone up, right?
No. Of course not.
You gotta give me something.
But if anyone, even military personnel outside of our unit, sees you, he'll have you court-martialed before you can blink.
Oh. That is all. That's evil.
I found myself a girlfriend.
Oh, she's my gosh.
Sweet. Helping me adjust to the move here and everything.
Oh.
Girl would be fun to cut up.
Barry, not every woman wants to be cut up. Really? I never bothered to ask. That's what I imagine him saying.
I'll need to see your entry visa, please.
Oh, boy.
Out of the way, everyone.
Yeah, that's the thing. It's no matter where you go in the world, it's like you have to have papers, please.
Yep.
It's true for us. I mean, no matter where we go, basically we have to have our papers. I mean, heck, there's some countries that don't even accept, like, travel visas from the U.S. anymore. You have to have, like, a full passport.
Hmm.
It's crazy. But, hey, once you get that passport, you basically have free reign to travel to most countries in the world. And, you know,
have you ever been out of the country?
Yes.
Where?
I've been to Mexico and I've been to Canada.
Oh, lucky.
Hey. Canada was nice, although it was snowing. It was during winter time. Yeah, I made the genius choice to go to Canada in the winter.
What part of Canada did you go to?
Toronto.
Oh.
Went to Toronto. I've been to Toronto. I've been to Quebec. I've been to Niagara, and I gotta say, I'd love to go to Edmonton, and I would also love to go to Vancouver. I heard Vancouver is like really awesome. And also, in Mexico, I have been to, I've been just across the border with my dad, and we flew to Cancun.
Oh.
Yeah.
You went to that part of Mexico.
Oh, yes.
Oh.
It was awesome. Cancun was a lot of fun. A lot of
Haven't
clubs
you been
down
to,
there.
Didn't you go somewhere with your mom? The Bahamas?
No, I had the opportunity, but I couldn't.
Oh.
Mom's more traveled than me. She's been to Europe. She's been, like, all throughout Europe. She had that huge trip.
Yeah.
I would have killed to go on that trip. Mom was actually in, like, the UK on its last night that it was part of the EU. And now it's a solo country.
I can't wait to see Miss Gracia and cute little Alicia.
Sounds good. We shouldn't be all that far behind you. I think it's best if we give Hughes the information that we found out first.
I'm pretty sure Hughes said he was aware in the court martial office.
This is gonna suck.
You ain't kidding. Oh,
oh
God.
My gosh.
For real?
Excuse me.
Oh.
Colonel?
Colonel Mustang.
Colonel Mustang? He did ask if there were any materials having to do with the fifth laboratory.
Mm.
And also, he was looking into the Hughes case.
What?
That's what I was thinking, dude. Literally, having a freaking character that can just, like, shapeshift into other characters in this show, I'm literally suspicious of almost everyone and almost every
single one. That's the thing. You have to be careful, like, who you talk to. That's why if I were...
like, with the like, at the Colonel, like, looking into Hughes, I was like, she's giving up information she shouldn't be giving to people that are going to get other people attacked.
Not only that, but I would do, like, info checks with people.
Yeah.
And I'll just be like, how was your trip in this morning? Did your bike break down again? And just be like, and they'll be like, I don't have a bike. It's just like, oh, well, okay then. And just like, just do stuff like that, because the homunculi would not be aware, and thus would probably just be like, you know, just make up something like, oh yeah, yeah, it, I had it taken care of though. And yeah. It's like, just like, and it would be at that point would just be like, okay, so I don't, it's like, I like, this person's not who they're pretending they are. I need to like watch what I say.
Or you could relay false information to...
That's true as well, but you don't know if that false information could wind up getting someone else hurt.
Oh, true.
Because it's at that point you just need to pantomime and just, you know, lead along. Don't give any information that may or may not be used against somebody that could wind up getting someone hurt. And it's basically like a spy game, almost. You know, because there are people out there who run espionage who basically have to lead double, sometimes triple lives in order to maintain their facade with people. And it's crazy how effective some of those people are. It's insane.
Hello, sir.
Oh.
So imagine him standing up from the john and just be like, all of a sudden his head peers over the top and be like, oh, Jesus.
Did you tell them about Hughes' death? I couldn't bring myself to do it. They'll find out eventually, you know. Yes. Found out something he would have been better off not knowing.
Not allowed to say.
If the Ulrich brothers found out what really happened to him, they would blame themselves.
Huh? Lieutenant Hawkeye? If the lieutenant's here, that means so is...
Thanks for waiting.
Yep, the colonel. And we were thinking that we'd pay Lieutenant Colonel Hughes a visit a little later today.
Oh.
Where is he, anyway?
Yeah, there's no getting around it now.
Not here. He retired out in the country and took his wife and daughter with him to take over the family business. Don't do anything crazy.
Okay.
Now, that's the right there. He's put the facade out. Like, you know, he's told that big lie, basically, to try and cover everything. But when Winry, I guarantee...
Yeah,
Winry's going to be the
gonna...
one...
figure it out.
Because, yeah.
And told them.
Yeah. That's just this place more trust. Like children.
You're in a hurry. Why the rush? We just heard about Lieutenant Colonel Hughes.
Oh, it's the other thing. Ross. Ross was the one that you know, Envy was imitating. So, we know that's one, you know, disguise that Envy has. So... is he talking to Envy or is he talking to Ross? You just don't know.
He was promoted. 2 whole ranks.
He retired to the country and they promoted him?
Oh, no. Oh.
Lieutenant Ross?
There it is.
I thought that was his name.
Motherfucker.
I was like, when she said his name earlier, I was like, it sounded like she said Focker.
Yeah. All of a sudden, here come all the meet the parents jokes. Just yeah. Like, it's like, now listen here. I wonder if he has a daughter named Martha. Now listen here, Martha fucker. It's gonna break Winry's heart too.
There's gonna be a bunch of apples dropped onto the ground.
That's symbolism, I guess. Of course, he'd blame himself.
Okay, you boys have a safe trip.
So Maze learned things about the Philosopher's Stone that someone didn't want him to know. His death was a message. A warning to you from whoever did it. You boys have to keep moving forward. Any way you can.
God. That's a strong woman right there, man. And the truth is, I think that Mustang lying to them was wrong.
I think so, too.
100%.
Yeah.
Because Mustang had it in his head that it would be a drawback for them to know, and they would blame themselves and they would sulk. But no, instead they went and they confronted it head on.
Like adults.
Yeah.
I mean, in Mustang's defense, the dude is consistently running on like 10 hours of sleep that he got 3 days ago.
Yeah, so, true.
I mean, he might not be in the best emotional decision-making state at all times.
And also, you can tell, like, whenever he came across Barry the Chopper, and he immediately asked Barry if, like, whenever Hughes came up, you felt the timbre in his voice change.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like he
was getting ready to turn him into atoms if he said it was him.
Exactly. And that's the emotional distress. I think Mustang is hiding it very well. And plus, on, you know, compound moving to Central, having to start fresh in Central, and not only that, but having
bigger responsibilities.
Bigger responsibilities and no sleep on top of that. Trying to find out who killed your best friend. I mean, yeah, I can see that.
Can't even enjoy that delicious looking steak right now.
No.
Winry, you in there? Apple pie?
I've practiced making it a few times. Gotten pretty good at it. I'm not nearly as good as Miss Gracie. I'd hope that Mr. Hughes would get to try some too.
He's either a born idiot or a clueless hustler. I'm off to gather some more intelligence.
Uh-oh.
Let's go, Gluttony.
Well, we've got a noisy mutt. Perhaps all he needs is a nice bone to chew.
You've been named as the primary suspect in the Brigadier General Hughes murder case. Come
on. Oh, come on.
There you go.
That's absurd. Second Lieutenant Maria Ross pleading not guilty on all charges.
Gather whatever information you can about her.
Ma'am, I'd like a bouquet of these, please.
My, what's this? A hot date, lover boy?
I got a new girlfriend.
Been waiting long, Solaris?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, no. I just got here.
Shit.
It's so good to see you, Jean.
Oh, my God.
Yes, you just see how deep the rabbit hole goes.
And that's what he's trying to do?
I'm not sure about homunculi, but, you know, that's... But all things considered, the whole thing with... just shows you how deep, like, the homunculi have their, like, grip on controlling information in the capital, and how good they are at manipulating things.
I'm sure she has quite the grip.
Oh my God.
What?
Grow up, man. But also, you know, she's got a grip, but also, you know, I think given her abilities, she's the one who's going to do all the penetrating.
Not into that. So.
No, I know. Me neither. But, hey, I don't think you'd really have a choice if you were involved with her.
I probably wouldn't get involved with her.
He's okay. Smart man.
Except for I don't think you'd realize that until it was too late.
Exactly. Yeah. I mean,
then you'd have to call the cops.
And then they'd be like, I'm sorry, sir. But all departments are busy. It's like, Envy, is that you? How'd you guess? And then, you know, Envy would hang up on you. They're like, well, I'm boned. And then you'd get sliced into ribbons. Oh, so yeah. That, them finding out about Hughes's passing and also just all the other stuff happening.
And yeah, now I like Ross, how you can kill a character like 10 episodes ago and then just bring it back up and make it sad again.
Well,
yeah.
Hate to say it, but it's like whenever a character goes, it's good that they address his absences, like the effect of his passing, not just on like the main characters, but also everyone else. I mean, we've seen how it affects Mustang. Mustang is angry. I think Mustang's already had his grieving period and his point where he's been sad. Now he's just angry and looking for vengeance.
Now it's definitely a stark contrast to what we've been watching recently, where, just in case Kate ever watches, I won't say the names, but, the show where a main character that's been there since the beginning that we liked a lot just got offed towards the very end.
Yeah.
And nobody even has time to grieve, you know?
That's true. And that one hurt. Mm-hmm. That one hurt a lot. And you see certain characters in this, they'll have that effect on you because it's just how caught up you get in caring about them. Well,
I'm starting to realize why everyone likes this anime so much is because it's not like a classic action shonen. It's a lot more a mystery show.
Yes.
And therefore it's normal things have time to go on in between all the paranormal things and the mystery and the dark shadowy
conspiracy stuff, shit. Yeah.
So whenever a character dies, you have time to slow down and take on the full weight of that. Unlike shows that are action oriented where they just want to get you back into the action after a character's out.
Yeah. And there are some shows that take a moment, but there are also moments in this show where the primary focus on a character's passing is the focal point of the episode. That's what this was. I mean, because we saw how it immediately affected everyone who was immediately aware of it. Now we're getting, the main... And that's a weird thing, because usually it's the main character who finds out first, and we get theirs, and then thus the splash reaction of, everyone else around them.
Yeah, half the time there's no way that a main side character would not die in front of the protagonist, unless it was, the protagonist was going to be immediately investigating it afterwards, but...
Yeah. And now speaking of investigation, now the spotlight is on Maria Ross, and you would hope that enough people would be there to have her back, but this is the thing. In Central, you have to assume that no one's on your side, because if the wolves start to turn on you, that's the thing. If you're running with the wolf pack and you're just running, all in unison together, working together, but then all of a sudden a little shade of doubt appears on you. Next thing you know, all those wolves go into self-preservation mode, and not only do they leave you behind, but they turn and then they eat you alive. Because, it's a dog-eat-dog world, unfortunately. And I'm hoping that
which I wonder how they even got her as a suspect, considering,
there didn't nobody seem to saw be that any happen. Witnesses.
Well, there weren't any witnesses that were found at the time. But if a witness comes forward,
Envy could change into whomever,
And Envy can basically make up any witness statement that he wants. And it'll be convincing because...
It's like can start matching things like her height to stab wounds and stuff like that.
Yes. And that then not crazy. Only, and then not only that, and but
footprints
also...
Footprints nearby, maybe.
Yeah.
Damn.
I mean, all it takes is a nut... It's like, it doesn't have to be 100% truth. You just have to have enough... have the right people believe you. And you can basically... You can basically go to jail, just off that. I mean, that's how it is in real life. I mean, the thing, they call it a jury of your peers, or, there is no jury, there's no... And instead, it's a pure, dependent upon, what the judge says.
That's why,
it doesn't matter.
As goofy and bass-ackwards as the fictional trial system in the Ace Attorney series actually is, one... detail that I really kind of enjoy about it, and especially just for the story elements it comes up with in that game, but
yeah,
they have a thing with their court system where if you are unable to prove that someone had a motive to commit a murder, then you can't convict them of that murder. You have to establish the motive, or you cannot convict them of it. Like, literally, there's a couple cases where it looks like the guy that everyone in the courtroom knows and they have, like, red-handed fucking proof that they killed somebody is about to just let, like, they're about to just let him walk out the door because they can't figure out why he would have wanted to. And, like, it's up to, like, you to basically establish that last minute. And that's the thing about her is, like, what motive would they be able to establish for her to kill Hughes? It doesn't make a lot of sense.
My guess would be it's just... they would say, Maria Ross, tell me, what was Mays Hughes, investigating? Just like, and how many other people knew about this? It's like, well, just me and a few others. It's like, yes. And when High Office found out about this, did you feel like you had to act, basically, they could make it to where, did you feel like you had to act on your own? In terms of implied orders of like the Fuhrer saying the investigation must stop, and because Hughes wouldn't stop and he was going to assault you with a knife, you took matters into your own hands. Then when you realized you'd gone too far, you ran away. Like
they can invent a story.
They can, yeah. There's narratives that people can invent, and you know she can deny it, but. But again, that's hearsay. This is why I really wish that there was something that like absolute truth. Like you basically just like do a viewfinder, just be like, okay, she's innocent. That motherfucker over there is a shapeshifter, and oh, he's running. Okay, and okay, yeah.
I wonder if Ed will figure it out though.
Maybe.
Like it's too late. Because wasn't Ross and the other guy outside his hospital room during the time that...
Well, no, Ed had left. Okay. And Hughes was killed just after that.
Okay.
So Ross and Raj
whether or not she has an actual alibi right now.
Where she was and who she was with.
And if Broach, her partner, you know, the blonde-haired guy, can... provide an alibi, be like, yeah, we were standing guard outside of the outside of Central at this station here. It's like, okay, was there anyone else there? No. You can see here on our report, we were both there until this specific time.
And then they can just be like, and since there was no one to confirm you were there, who's to say you weren't there with her while she killed Hughes?
And the next thing you know, and
you get dragged into it too.
Yes. Because having one person have the blame, that's one thing. Having two people like get the blame, that's another. Like mm-hmm. that, and that'd be horrible if both Ross and Roach both had to take the blame for it. But anyway, we'll see how this plays out in the next few episodes, hopefully. But for now. Until next time, everybody. Signing off, I'm Nate.
I'm Kate.
I am Nick.
Y'all be good people. Take care. Peace.